permeability of soils. If you recollect, permeability, it is an engineering property of soil. It is an engineering property of soil. It is an property of soil. It is defined as the ability of the soil. Permeability is defined as the ability of the soil wherein which allows and passes fluids through it. Which allows and passes fluids through it means the in the name permeability, ability to permit, that is what is permeability. It is defined as permeability is defined as ability of soil which allows and passes fluids through it, which allows and passes fluids through it. Yes, it is defined as the ability of the soil which allows and passes fluids through it. This is the definition of permeability. Now, before entering into permeability, we will learn or we will recollect some basics from fluid mechanics. Like we have to recollect our Bernoulli's theorem. Bernoulli's theorem. Yes. What is Bernoulli's theorem? In a steady state steady state irrotational incompressible uniform steady state irrotational incompressible flow through a channel, it may be conduit also, flow through channel, sum of total head, at any given point, at any two given points is constant. Here, total head TH is equal to pressure head, or this is also known as potential head, plus velocity head, kinetic head, pressure head, velocity head, that. That is total head TH is equal to pressure head, velocity head, datum head. These three gives our total head. So Bernoulli's theorem says that in a flow which is steady state, irrotational, incompressible, if I check these three values, these three, that is total head at this point must be equal to total head at this point. This is point A, point B, fluid is flowing like this, fluid is flowing through the channel. Now if I insert a piezometer here, I get pressure head. Due to flow, I'll get velocity head and I'll get datum. This is datum. Now sum of all these three heads, pressure head, velocity head, datum head, must be same. Whatever the total head I get here, total head at A must be equal to total head at B. This is what is Bernoulli's theorem. Is it okay? Yes. But in practice, it may not happen because there might be losses. Once water is flowing through this conduit or through the channel, there might be some of the losses. Due to that losses, whatever the head causing flow which we see at A, same head causing flow may not be seen at B. B reason is due to losses. If I consider a conduit, we have friction losses here. Major losses, friction losses may encounter here. Due to that friction losses, the pressure head may be dropped. This is what actually happens in practice. This is Bernoulli's theorem. You note down, and we correlate this Bernoulli's theorem to our soils now. Yes, you copy down. There is no necessary to draw this diagram. I will draw this diagram for soils. Just copy down the theory part what we have written here. Is it okay? Finished? Now I will give a small diagram. Try to calculate total heads. Let us assume there is a reservoir. The reservoir wherein water is stored. This is the level of water and the height of water is h. And reservoir outflow is zero. That means flow through reservoir is zero. Now we need to calculate. I will consider two points in this reservoir. This is top of reservoir point A, bottom of reservoir point B. I am considering two points, that is point A, top of the reservoir is point A, bottom of the reservoir is point B. Similarly, I am considering the base of the reservoir. This is being datum surface. This is being datum. Now you calculate total head difference. Total head difference between points A and B. This is the question. Calculate total head difference. Total head difference between points A and B. This is our question. Yes, you try to calculate what is total head at A and total head B, and what is the difference between these two points. Yes, first at A, pressure head. What is pressure head at A? Yes, how to find out pressure head? We were discussed in the last session how to find out pressure head. Yes, to determine pressure head, you insert a piezometer at point A. The water level showing in the piezometer is piezometric head causing flow. We want that piezometric head. Yes, piezometric head causing pressure, not flow. Now here we want that pressure head. Now if you see here, what water level shows in the piezometer? It is zero. No water in the piezometer, no pressure. And kinetic head, is there any flow is taking place? No. Kinetic head can be calculated once flow is taking place. If there is flow in the soil, then only we can record kinetic head or velocity head. So since there is no flow here, no kinetic head. Next one. Datum head at A. Yes. What is the level difference between datum surface and point A? What is the height? That is H. Why? Because this has been considered as datum. From datum, point A is located at H. Therefore, this is H. What is the total head now? TH is equal to H. Since VH is 0, velocity head is 0, we will get only pressure head, datum head. Come to at B. At B, now you calculate pressure head and datum head. Yes, what will be the pressure head at B? How much it will be? What we have to do? Insert a piezometer. To determine pressure head at B, we need to insert a piezometer at B. This is what the insertion of piezometer. On insertion, we can see the, this is the water level in the piezometer. Water level in the piezometer. How much is that? H. And datum head. What is datum head? Since point B is located on the datum surface, therefore it is 0. What is total head? It is H. At A, it is H. At B, it is H. What is the question? Total head difference between points A and B. This is the question. Total head difference between point A and B. What is the value? Head difference between point A and B. Total head difference between A and B. 0. Is 0. This is the answer. Yes, try to understand from now onwards in this topic and the seepage through soils. We will be talking about the total head. Total problems, whatever the concepts we do, whatever the problems we do, all depends upon this total head. Total head is equal to pressure head plus datum head plus velocity head, but we don't consider velocity head in soils. Why? Because in soils, velocity is very low velocity. If you recollect the formula V square by 2G, it is V. V is very low value. In soils, still low value. That is the reason we don't consider V here. Yes, you copy down this one. Friends, finish. I'll erase the first one. Now, if we consider velocity head, yes, just now I told total head is equal to pressure head, velocity head and datum head. Recollect the formula V square upon 2G. It's a constant value, whereas velocity head is varying square times of its velocity. Therefore, as velocity is reduces, VH is reduced by root times. That's the reason in soils, velocity of flow is very small. It flows at a very small velocity. Therefore, velocity head is will be very, very small value, and this is neglected. What is neglected? Velocity head is neglected in soils. Therefore, in soils, total head TH is equal to pressure head plus datum head. You remember this one. Pressure head and datum head. This is what happens. Okay. In soils, velocity of flow through the soils. Here we can write velocity of flow through the soils. Velocity of flow through the soils is very small. Therefore, VH will be very, very small actually. It is very, very small value, and this is neglected in soils. Therefore, in soils, total head will be equal to pressure head plus datum head. This is the equation. Now, what happens in soils? What happens to our total head in soils? We'll see that one. as water flow through soils yes I will consider a I will consider an aquifer which is impervious at the bottom as well as at the top impervious at the bottom as well as impervious at the top here I have considered two points this is point A this is point B and these are all soil granules these are all soil granules now through this medium through this soil medium water flows through this soil medium now what happens once water flows through the soil medium the energy which is present in the soil whatever the energy total energy or total head present in the soil will gets reduced why it is getting reduced because whatever the water passes through the soil it is subjected for obstruction by the soil particles once it is traveling in the soil the water which is traveling here is subjected for obstruction this is how he gets obstructed this is obstruction okay obstruction this is what he takes the path like this again will be obstruction due to this obstructions he will lose he will means water will lose some of the energy which he has at this point once reach up to B I am considering point A point B the distance between these two points are L distance between point A and point B is L seepage length what call seeped length or traveled distance now I have inserted a piezometer at A and a piezometer at B I have inserted two piezometers piezometer at A and piezometer at B in the soil now what happens once the piezometer is inserted here water level rises in the piezometer why it rises because here it's a aquifer it's a confined aquifer which is impervious at top and bottom water available in the aquifer is under pressure artesian pressure therefore once you insert a piezometer once you insert a borewell here water rises in the piezometer this is the water level at point A similarly what happens to water level here whether it will maintain same level or it will vary yes whether it will maintain same level at point B or it will vary yes yes obviously it will vary as I've just now said as the water is passing through the soils it will lose some of its energy what energy is as total energy what is total energy here total head what is the total head pressure head datum head only two velocity as we have neglected so whatever the total head which has at A they might be not same total head at B therefore water level in the piezometer gets reduced here I am taking this as pressure at A PA pressure head at A PA pressure head at B PB this is pressure head at A PA pressure head at B PB similarly I have assumed here somewhere datum surface this is datum surface and from this datum the elevation head up to A is ZA and elevation head at B B ZB elevation head at A I have assumed ZA elevation at B I have assumed ZB now you see here total head at A will be equal to What is the value? I will erase this portion. What is the total head at A and total head at B? We need to calculate head difference. Question, what is the question is? Total head difference between points A and B. What is the total head difference between A and B? This is our question. Now, total head at A. Yes. At A. What is pressure head? What is pressure head at A? The recorded value in the piezometer, that is PA, I have written here. That is PA. And datum head at A, ZA. Similarly, total head will be equal to PA plus ZA. At B, what is pressure head? It is shown PB. What is datum head? It is shown ZB. What is total head? PB plus ZB. This is our total head. Now question is, total head difference between A and B. Now total head at A is PA plus ZA minus PB minus ZB. This is TH difference, total head difference. The total head difference. Now if you see, ZA and ZB are located at the same height. Since ZA and ZB are located at same height, they get cancelled. That is, since ZA is equal to ZB, datum head at A is equal to datum head B. Now we see here, what we get here? Total head difference, PA minus PB, pressure head at A minus pressure head at B. This is our total head difference, and this is what we call delta H, where delta H is head loss. What is this? This was the actual total energy line. This is what the line we got by joining these two, and this is delta H. It's a small h, not capital H. It is delta H. Now connecting, see here, this is imaginary line is total energy line, TEL. Now by joining water levels in two piezometers, we get A line can be drawn by joining water levels in two piezometers, and it is named as hydraulic gradient line, HGL, hydraulic gradient line, HGL. This is the hydraulic gradient line. The imaginary line, water level here, water level must be here, but due to losses, head water level have been dropped. Imaginary line is TEL. This is HGL, hydraulic gradient line. Yes. Next, slope of HGL is slope of hydraulic gradient line I is given by slope of hydraulic gradient line I is given by, this is slope I is equal to, is given by opposite by adjacent, tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent, that is I is equal to slope of hydraulic gradient line is hydraulic gradient I, where I is equal to opposite by adjacent, that is delta H upon L, where delta H is equal to head loss between two points and L is C page length between two points. This is what is hydraulic gradient I. Yes, you copy down all this. Just copy down. I am erasing this one. Yes. Where hydraulic gradient I is defined as head loss per C page length. That's what we have written. Hydraulic gradient I is defined as head loss, ratio of head loss upon C page length. This head loss can be head causing flow, head loss, total head causing flow, whatever it may be. In future, we will modify this one into delta H. I will write it as capital H, small h. Yes, but it is the same concept. I is equal to delta H by. Now, Darcy's law. Darcy's law. Darcy's law. For laminar flow condition, for laminar flow condition, the velocity of flow, velocity of flow is directly proportional, for laminar flow condition, the velocity of flow is directly proportional to hydraulic gradient I. Hydraulic gradient I. That is equal to V is directly proportional to I. This is for flows, for water flows. Now, in soils, this velocity is governed by a parameter. Velocity through soils is governed by a parameter. Is governed by a parameter k, small k, it is known as small k, parameter k known as coefficient of permeability. It is coefficient of permeability, small k. In soils, velocity in soils is governed by, right, like this. Velocity through soils is governed by a parameter k known as coefficient of permeability. Therefore, in soils, V can be written as K into I. V is equal to K into I. Now, if you recollect, discharge Q is equal to A into V, and V can be written as Q by A. V can be written as Q by A. Therefore, here V will be equal to, we are replacing V with Q by A. Q by A is equal to KI. Q by A is equal to KI. Q by A is equal to K into I, or else Q is equal to K into I into A. This is also Darcy's formula. Q is equal to, that is, discharge through the soils is equal to coefficient of permeability multiplied by product of coefficient of permeability, its hydraulic gradient, and cross section of the soil is discharge through soils. Yes, Q is equal to K into I into A. Yes, copy down that portion. This K value will vary from soil to soil. Whatever the K I have written, it will vary from soil to soil. Now, I have given that velocity of flow is equal to coefficient of permeability multiplied by hydraulic gradient. If you see, velocity of flow under unit hydraulic gradient, that is, when I is equal to 1, V will be equal to K. Very, very important. Remember it. Velocity of flow under unit hydraulic gradient is given that V is equal to K when I is equal to 1. Yes, here K, I have written that known as coefficient of permeability. One more term, K is also known as, there is one more name for K. K is also known as coefficient of hydraulic conductivity. K is also known as coefficient of hydraulic conductivity. Coefficient of permeability or coefficient of hydraulic conductivity. K varies upon, or K depends upon, K varies from soil to soil. K varies from soil to soil and most of it depends upon size of soil. Primarily, K depends upon its size of soil. K varies from soil to soil and most of it depends upon size of soil. It has so many factors affecting, but major is size of soil. If you see here how K varies, I am taking soil type and K, what will be the units for K? Velocity is equal to K, therefore units for K is how much? Units for K will be same as velocity, centimeter per second, meter per day, etc. So I am taking here soil type K in centimeter per second. First one is gravel. For gravel, K will be varied from 100 centimeter per second to 1 centimeter per second. 100 centimeter per second to 1 centimeter per second. Sand, it is 1 centimeter per second to 10 to the power of minus 3 centimeter per second. For sand, it is 1 centimeter per second to 10 to the power of minus 3 centimeter per second. For silt, 10 to the power of minus 3 centimeter per second to 10 to the power of minus 6 centimeter per second. For clay, it will be less than 10 to the power of minus 6. And here, gravel is known as, in terms of permeability, gravel is known as, again in sand we have partition, fine sand, medium sand, coarse sand, in which we can treat fine sand under semi-pervious, but we will write here gravel as pervious soil. Sand also pervious soil. Both gravel and sand are pervious soil. Whereas silt, semi-pervious soil. Silt is known as semi-pervious soil. Whereas clay is known as impervious. It is impervious soil. Pervious, semi-pervious, impervious. Yes, you copy down. Yes, students, this is Finish. I'm erasing the previous one. Yes, read once. What is Darcy's law? Read once. What is Darcy's law? Yes, in laminar flow condition, that is, flow must be laminar only. Laminar flow, that is layered flow, like this. This is the laminar flow. This laminar flow can be possible only these two soils, fine grained soils. These two are called fine grained soils, those two are called coarse grained soils. Here in silt and clay, laminar flow can be possible. Whereas in these two soils, laminar flow not may be possible. Yes? Next. You put side heading discharge velocity and seepage velocity. What is the difference between discharge velocity and seepage velocity? Discharge velocity V is the assumed velocity. It is an assumed velocity. V is equal to, just now we have written Q is equal to A into V. Whereas seepage velocity denoted with Vs is the actual velocity at which fluid is passing through soils. Seepage velocity Vs is the actual velocity at which fluid is passing through soils. Now, here again, Q is equal to, instead of A, passing through soils means through voids some might is. From where water is flowing through soils, through the voids present in the soil, through which water is passing. Therefore, how I will change? Discharge will be same. Q is equal to, instead of A, I will take it as AV. Instead of V, I will take it as Vs. Earlier it was Q is equal to AV. Now, Q is equal to area of void cities, where AV is area of voids into seepage velocity Vs. Discharges are same. Where AV is equal to area of voids. Since discharge is same, Therefore, by equating, since discharge is same, therefore, by equating the above two, that is A into V is equal to, that is A into V is equal to AV into VS. I am erasing this one. A into V is equal to, here I am writing, AV into VS. We want to calculate what is VS. VS is equal to A into V upon AV. A into V upon AV. Yes. Just recollect, this is cross section area of soil. Now what I will do, sir, area of void. Now what I will do, this is a cross section area. Yes, I will consider 1 meter as the depth here. I will consider 1 meter as the depth. Therefore, how we can write? Vs is equal to A into 1 into V, that is velocity, upon AV into 1. Vs is equal to area into depth gives volume into velocity, upon area into V into 1 gives volume of voids. Therefore, if you recollect, n is equal to volume of voids upon total volume, porosity n. I will bring this v, seepage velocity, vs is equal to velocity upon vv upon v. That can be written as seepage velocity, vs is equal to discharge velocity, vs is equal to discharge velocity upon porosity of soil. This is one more form.